was a time I truly believed that I could do it on my own. But all that I found at the end of that road is that concept for me was all wrong. But I found a savior who turned me around when he placed his love on me. And I will trust him.
Bless the Lord for another privilege. It's the month of April, the month of resurrection. God is worthy to be praised. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This is Shepherd Hill Baptist Church Online. It is time for prayer. Can you just open your mouth wherever you are and whisper to God that you love Him? Just give Him praise, give Him thanks, celebrate Him, let Him know that you are grateful. Give Him all the glory. Worship His majesty for the gift of life, for the sun health, for His many blessings. God is awesome. God is worthy to be praised. He's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He's our helper, our defender, our supporter, our sustainer. He's our King. Lord, we thank You. Lord, we worship You. Glory be to Your name. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be glorified. Thank You, Father. Forever You will be the Lamb upon the throne. We celebrate You. Thank You, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we give thanks. Father, we thank You for this time. We are grateful for Your mercy over our lives, over our nation. As a matter of fact, over the entire world. King of glory, we praise You because You never change. You remain the same. We thank You, Father, because You are the Lord who rules in the affairs of men. We celebrate You. We magnify You. We praise You. We adore Thee. We worship You. Please accept our thanks in the name of Jesus, our King and our God. We have come again to meet with You. We have come, eternal King, to receive of You. We have come to Your presence because we believe it's sure we are going to find hope. We are going to receive help. We are going to receive blessing. Our King and our God, we are expectant. We are looking up unto You. Our God, we pray at this worship experience. It's immaterial. Our location. May we find You in the name of Jesus. May we receive Your grace in the name of Jesus. This morning we pray that this service, that Your power will come down. Your glory will come down. Your presence will come down. Thank You, Father. And Lord eternal, in the course of this service, You will do wonders. You will do great and mighty things. You fill our heart with joy, and we shall testify. Thank You, Father. Glory be to Your name, Lord. We pray for Your servants. Today, you use Him again in a mighty way, in a powerful way. Glory be to Your name, Lord. In Jesus Christ's mighty and wonderful name, we pray. Amen. Once again, in that name that is higher than every other name, And on behalf of our Father and the Lord, I celebrate you, I appreciate you, I glorify God for your life, for your commitment to be in attendance at this service. May you really be blessed. After this experience, may you have testimony. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Shout hallelujah.
We shall sing from the Baptist hymn now. Hymn 102, Ride On, Ride On in Majesty.
To please pick your Bibles and let's open together to Gospel according to St. John. We shall be reading from chapter 12 and we shall read verses 12, 13, 14, and 15. John chapter 12 from verse 12 through 15. The next day, a great multitude that had come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, and cried out, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel. Then Jesus, when he had found a young donkey, sat on it, as it is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's coat. May the Lord bless our life this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Amen. The crowd are flying the narrow streets to see this man from Galilee. He's just a carpenter, some say, and he's leading fools astray. Yet many need to give him praise, and in his eyes the gleams, the power that sees the hearts of all men, and he knows his father's mind, he speaks his father's ways, for he comes in the name of the Lord. And there is strength in the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of the Lord. There is hope in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And when my plans have fallen through, and when my strength is nearly gone, when there's nothing left to do but just depend on you, and the power of your name, and as we call upon your name, your strength through our weakness to show, we can know the master's plan, extends the master's hand, when we come in the name of the Lord. And there is strength in the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of the Lord. There is hope in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the His name will be worshipped forever. His creator, redeemer, and king. Oh, there is strength in the name of the Lord. Oh, there is power in the name of the Lord. There is hope in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes. Blessed.
blessed is he who comes. Blessed is he who comes. In the name of the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. At such a time as this, when we are weary of who should come into our homes, now everybody is careful of who comes into his or her house, because you are afraid the fellow may come with the unwanted coronavirus. I come this morning to declare to you that there is somebody that you can invite him to your home. He is King Jesus. And blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. It's my prayer that on this Palm Sunday, as we worship together his majesty, the Lord himself will begin something fresh, something unique, something special in your life, in my life, even as we go to this service at this hour, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Shall we pray together? Mighty Father, King of glory, what a time in your presence. Thank you because in spite of the current predicament, you are still showing yourself strong in our lives. Daddy, definitely you are teaching us a lesson. You are getting us closer. You are drawing us nearer to you. Lord, I have no doubt you are walking and you are still walking even in this circumstance. I simply ask that this hour, that Lord, do your work. Walk your walk and let your purpose be established even at such a time as this. And Daddy, as I bring this word to your people, I ask, Lord, that everyone who hears this word now and later shall be touched, shall be refreshed, shall receive strength and hope in spite of what we are going through. And may come to terms that you are working on our behalf to make something good out of this experience that we are passing through. Holy Spirit, have your way. Mighty God, move among us. Save souls to this message. Restore life, grant courage and encouragement. Forgive sins and give us a new life through the power of your word. In Jesus' precious, powerful, and potent name we pray. Amen. Today is Palm Sunday and we give praise to God in spite of the challenges we all are going through. May the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ visit us individually and visit our world collectively. I have no doubt that at the end of this celebration this week, the world will soon see the power of Jesus. Palm Sunday commemorates the triumphant entry of Jesus Christ into Jerusalem as he rode on a donkey. You know, in many of our churches, especially in the villages, days like these, people will go about having palms like the one I put in the front here, and making some all kinds of designs. Some will make crosses out of the palms, signifying the triumphant entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. My prayer is that may we all triumph over our challenges. May this be the week of triumph for the world over that challenge that we are all grappling with in the name of Jesus. And whatever your challenges are, I decree and I prophesy that this week will usher you into a season of unending triumph in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We will triumph over our situations, over our troubles, over our circumstances, And even all our enemies, both seen and unseen, known and unknown, in the mighty name of Jesus. His riding on a donkey was a fulfillment of the ancient prophecy found in Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. In Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9, the prophecy had come earlier that Jesus, the coming king, will ride on a donkey. The word of God says, rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. All the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, recorded this triumphal entry. But John became so important to me at this time because John made it clear that his riding on the donkey was a fulfillment of a prophecy. That what was happening was already foretold before the time it came. And I'm praying for someone out of my voice that no matter how long it has been, may the laws of the Lord find fulfillment in your life in the name of Jesus. Every age-long prophecy that the enemy had been able to stop, I decree and declare, they will find fulfillment in your life in the name of Jesus. The palm branches which the people held in their hands and possibly spreaded on the ground for him to pass through on the road was a symbol of joy and triumph. Hallelujah. The symbol of joy and triumph as recorded in Leviticus 23 verse 40. I love to read that. Leviticus 23 verse number 40. There the word of God says, and you shall take for yourselves on the first day the fruit of beautiful trees, branches of palm trees, and boughs of leaf trees, and willows of the brook, and you shall rejoice before the Lord your God. How many days? 7 days. I come to declare to you that in spite of what we are passing through, may this be your season of rejoicing. The devil wants us to begin to cry and to be sad. But I decree and proclaim at this hour, by the mercies of the Lord God Almighty, this shall be your season, my season, our season of rejoicing. Because as the Lord liveth, after we have triumphed over this challenge, greater rejoicing shall be your portion, my portion, in the name of Jesus. With loud acclamations, the people welcome the king to the royal city. Today, the message of God to us all is lifted from that same passage, John chapter 12, verse 15. As they laid the palm branches on the road, as they celebrated him, as they shouted, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The Bible says in verse 6, verse 15, fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming. And today the Lord has sent me to you. Whether you are a man or woman, the word of God says, fear not, your king is coming. If I were you, I would say to myself, and I would mention my name, Israel Christy Lere, fear not, my king is coming. Fear not, my king is coming. Whatever may be trying to bring fear to you, say to yourself, fear not, my king, he's coming. There's so many things going on at this hour, many news, many podcasts, many audio messages and they are trying to bring fear on our hearts. I say to you, if you are one of the daughters of Zion or the sons of Zion, if you belong to Jesus, you have nothing to fear in this hour. Fear not! It's a sign that your king is coming. And very soon our king will come. My prayer is that may you be ready for his coming. Today many of us are struck with fear. And this fear is paralyzing many things in our lives. What many people are fearing today is not just the coronavirus, but the attendant challenges that are around heat. The truth is that 90% of what we fear today are not real at all. The great author by the name Zig Ziglar says, fear is false evidence appearing real. The devil uses our gullibility to tie us down with a spirit of fear. But whatever our fears are, we have a king that is greater than our fears. We have a king that is greater than the circumstances creating our fears. We have a king that is greater than coronavirus. We have a king that is greater than the devil that is manufacturing our fears. You may ask me, who is that king? He's King Jesus. And the Bible says he is coming. He is coming in the name of the Lord. He is coming not as a usurper, but he's coming as the one to whom the throne belongs to by divine appointment. He's coming to take over his throne. He's coming to take over his kingdom. And I decree every kingdom of this world that the devil and his agents have taken in the past, the king will come and take over in the name of Jesus. Every area of your life that the enemy has taken over, the king is coming to take over his throne in the name of Jesus. Whatever your fears are, the word of the Lord says to you today, on this Palm Sunday, fear not, your king is coming. What a message of hope. Fear not. Fear not what is happening to the world. Fear not the news you are hearing around. Fear not the gimmicks people are putting into this situation, causing more fright and panic. Fear not. Your king is coming. Hallelujah. You may say to me, Pastor, you said I should fear not. My king is coming. Actually, I didn't say that. The word of God says so. I only lifted it for you. You may ask me, Pastor, what is the king coming to do? What will the king come to do in our lives? In our world at such a time as this? At this peculiar time in the history of our world? Three things I believe the king is coming to do. Three things I believe our king is coming to do. In your life, in my life, in our world. Number one, the king is coming to confound his foes. Hallelujah. Your king is coming to confound, to disturb, to dislodge your foes. I don't know what your foes are. I don't know what your troubles are. I don't know what your challenges are. But I come to declare that your king is coming to confound, to dislodge, to disgrace your foes in the name of Jesus. And I declare today that that same king is coming to confound the demon by the name coronavirus. You know, for the first time, those who hated Jesus, those who didn't like his face, those who have spoken ill of him, when he came into Jerusalem on a donkey, they were all confounded. They were walking like, they were watching like Mumu. Is he not the capital son? Is that not the same Jesus we've been seeing? See him riding like a king. I decree to you, wherever people have actually done look down on you, May your king come to confirm them. But more than that, Jesus confounded them also in the temple. He will confound your foes and your troubles in the name of Jesus. And number two, the king is coming to console his friends. He's coming to console us. There's no doubt the impact of what has gone is going on in the world is so high on many of us. Some physically, some spiritually, some financially, some maritally, and so on and so forth. Some have had causes to lose their loved ones in this midst of all these challenges. And the world needs a consolation. The world needs a comfort at such a time as this. And I come to declare the king is coming to console his friends. Are you a friend of Jesus, the king? No matter what you are going through, I declare that he's with you. And he's coming to bring you comfort. May you receive the comfort of the Spirit at such a trying moment as this in the name of Jesus. What the world needs today is Jesus. We all need Jesus. What we are passing through is a sign that we need Jesus to bring consolation and comfort to our world. As many who have rejected him, it is time for you to receive him to your life, because the king is coming to console his friends. Just put your trust in him. And number three, the king is coming to complete his work. Has the Lord begun a good work in you? The Bible says he will perfect it. The king is coming to perfect his work. Philippians 1:6 says, he who begun a good work in me will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Being confident of this thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. And I say, whatever the Lord has begun in your life personally, he will complete it in the name of Jesus. According to Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9, you can rejoice, and you can rejoice greatly. Listen to me, people of God. It's our time to rejoice. It's our time to rejoice greatly. How I wish you can see what the Lord is working at this time. I wish you can see the impact the Lord is making over his word. The word the devil and his agents have snatched to their own purpose. Somebody was saying, for the so first time, those who claim to have freedom to do whatever they like. No, we live in a world people say now, I have my human rights. Nobody is talking about human rights. Nobody is talking about my own freedom now. I have freedom to marry a goat. It's my choice to marry another man, and I'm a man. Everybody has realized that there are certain norms I cannot go into. For the first time, one man in America is one of the newcaster who say he doesn't like to listen to regulation. He doesn't obey rules. Just last week, I discovered he also caught coronavirus. He's now under quarantine. He's a brother to a governor. And now he's obeying rules. He said, I didn't like to obey rules. What a demonic spirit. But God is working. And those of us who belong to him must realize our king is coming, and that should give us joy. Your king is just, and he will do justice to your case. Your king is coming. He is a just king, and he will do justice to your case. He will come to save you. So rejoice and be glad. On this day, we can afford to rejoice. Those of us who belong to him, he said, fear not, daughter of Zion. It's not everybody. Daughter of Zion. Those who belong to him. Your king. Not just the king. Your own king. The king you are surrendered to, the Lord of your life is coming. You can afford to rejoice and be glad. The big question this morning is, how many of us here who are under my voice can say we are sons and daughters of Zion? Have you turned your life to the Lord Jesus Christ? Are you one of those that belong to him? Are you one of those who are living according to his will? Have you surrendered your life to the Lord Jesus Christ? Have you repented of your sins? Are you born again? In the midst of what we are passing through, though it's a general problem for the world, but I come to say, fear not, your king is coming. Rejoice and be glad. I can hear the Lord saying, you will soon rule in the midst of your enemies. If you are yet to become a daughter of Zion or a son of Zion, I want to invite you at this hour to take this moment as your moment of decision, your time of turning around, your time of regeneration, your salvation period, and say to Jesus, I want to surrender to you. I don't want to continue to live that life I've been living, that wayward life, that unbelieving life, that sinful life. It is time I come to Jesus, for Jesus is coming. The king is coming. Jesus, the king, is coming. All that you and I are seeing are pointing us to the fact that the Lord is coming. The coming of the Lord will be sooner than we can imagine. As many who have been saying what we have written in the scripture doesn't matter. Oh, I don't think that can happen. Now you know that those things written in the book of Revelation can actually happen. And what you and I are seeing are just a sign of what could happen in this world. It is time to surrender to the king. For the king is coming. The real king of this world, King Jesus, is coming. For those of us who have known him, we need not to fear. We need not to be afraid. Don't be afraid of the challenges. Don't be afraid of the news. Don't be afraid of all kinds that you find on Facebook, on WhatsApp, on YouTube. Your king is coming. And through this week, as we pass through the Passion period, it's called the Passion Week. Up to the time the Lord was arrested and he was crucified and his resurrection, in the span of 7 days, the world will see the power of Jesus. His glory shall be revealed. But you and I can rejoice now, even before the time comes, because the king is coming. I see the king coming over Nigeria. The king coming over the world. The king coming over our circumstances. And giving us the victory earlier than we can imagine. In the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus, the king, is coming. I say, are you prepared for his coming? Are you ready for him to come into your life, into your home, into your circumstance, into your marriages? Can we please pray together? Wherever you are, can you be up, standing on your feet as we pray together?
Hosanna in the highest, let my King be
highest. Let
Rasa baba se teleboye. Rasa taba ye bo se teleboye manawa. I my king be lifted up. Hosanna. One more time. Hosanna. Appreciate God for the privilege to be alive at this time. Begin to exalt Him, begin to magnify Him. Worship His Majesty. Today is Palm Sunday, the triumphant entry day. Begin to say to the Lord, "You are my King. Take over my life. If you are under my voice, you need to give your life to Jesus. Just place your right hand on your chest now and say this word of prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I know you are the King. You are coming to save your own. Lord Jesus, I give my life to you today. I confess my sins. Help me to turn a new leaf. Empower me to live for you. Lord Jesus, redeem me by your blood. Save me by your grace. Let no devil, no demon be able to overcome me again. Oh, you spirit of sin, be far from me. Jesus, make me ready for your coming. Save me by your blood. Now you are my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. As many who have prayed that prayer, Heavenly Father, accept them to your kingdom and let your glory surround them. Save them by your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Just a few more prayer points. We are going to pray together. The Bible says the King is coming. 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 What is he coming to do? To confound. To confound his enemies, our troubles. Lift your right hand and say, "My Father, my Father, every power that is troubling this world by whatever name, whether coronavirus or other unseen viruses or other unseen powers that are troubling our world, Lord, come and confound them. Pull them to shame. Every authority that is not of yours in this world, the virus of sin, the virus of disobedience, the virus of all manners of shameful deeds that are taking over our world, confound at this hour. Thank you, Mary Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Display your power this week of passion, this week of resurrection. And let the world know that you are in charge of this world. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray. The King is coming to comfort or console his friends. Place your right hand on your chest. If you are one of his friends, pray to the Lord and say, "Father, console my heart. Comfort me. Let your peace reign in my heart. In this challenge, may I not lose my peace. May I not lose my hope in you. May I not lose my faith. Help me to be strong. Help me to be strong. Let the peace of God that transcends human understanding come into my life. Glorify yourself in my life, oh God. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray." And also, the King is coming to perfect his work. Let's pray together and say, "My Father, my Father, every work you have started in my life, bring to perfection, whether spiritual or physical. Complete your work. Lord, complete your work in our world. Complete your work in our nation, Nigeria. Lord, accomplish your purpose in this generation. Thank you, mighty Father. In Jesus' name we pray." And also, I want you to pray. Say after me, "My Father, my Father, help me to be ready for your coming. I know you are coming. Jesus, you are coming to take over your world. Help me to be ready. May I not be found wanting at your coming. Lord, help me to be ready. for your coming. For the King is coming. The King is coming. Let the world hear clearly. The King is coming. Let the world hear clearly. The King is coming. Let the world power hear clearly. The King is coming. Let those who are scheming to take over the affairs of the world know the King, the real King is coming. Jesus, help me to be ready for your coming. Begin to thank him for he has answered you. Begin to thank him because he has answered you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Mighty Father, what a time in your presence. What an hour of your glory. Be glorified, be magnified. We know you are coming. And you say we can afford to rejoice. And not ordinary rejoicing, but greatly rejoice. For you are coming. Lord, it gives us joy. You are coming to save us. You are coming to deliver us. You are coming to heal us. You are coming to encourage us. And Lord, I say today, all that we need at this hour, you will supply. Your children will stand strong. No devil will be able to defeat us. No schemes of man will be able to bring us down. We shall be strong for thee. And Lord, at your coming, we shall not be found wanting. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for this day. We will rejoice in you, even as we go to this Passion Week, for we know you are coming. Thank you, mighty Father. Receive the glory. Receive the honor. Receive the majesty. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Fear not. Your King is coming. Fear not. Our King is coming. Fear not. Your King is coming. Hallelujah. It's a privilege to have you worship the Almighty at this hour. Even as you watch online, I have no doubt that this week, listen to me as the Lord speaks to me at this hour, this week will be a unique week in the affairs, not only in Nigeria, in the affairs of men over the current challenge. This week will usher in the victory, the triumph that we all desire. The world can never remain the same again, for Jesus will be exalted over the affairs in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What an opportunity to worship His Majesty. It is time to give back to the Lord. Your worship without offering is not complete. If you are privileged to give wherever you are, whether it's your tithe or your offering, you can send to that account, Shepherd Baptist Church, and as you give to the Lord, it will bless you. This is not a moment of sadness for us. The Bible says, rejoice greatly, daughter of Zion. Fear not, for your King is coming. And as we sing, wherever you are, you can make transfer to that account. In the next 5 minutes, you can be doing that as we give to the Almighty. And now we can sing and praise Him and worship Him and glorify His holy name. Go ahead and sing.
All that men will praise the Lord.
All that men will praise the Lord.
Broken the gates.
And blessings and triumph for you and I. I mean, this will be the week of unusual triumph. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before I close the service, let me make it clear that tomorrow, by the grace of God, there's going to be a 24-hour prayer chain that is encouraged by the camp president. For all Christians, and especially those of us who are Baptists, are being our president as well. For those of us in our conference, our own prayer chain time is from 4 to 5 p.m. tomorrow. I want to encourage every child of God, every family, to take time to pray within that window. And the prayer points will be sent to many of us who are members on our WhatsApp. We are praying for victory. I have this deep conviction in my heart. I just get it clarified now and now. This week will be unique in the affairs of men. I have no doubt. Somebody just telling me I'm getting the clearer picture. By the time we are celebrating the resurrection, next week Sunday, we are equally celebrating victory over coronavirus. The strength of that demon shall be defeated. As the Lord goes to the grave, he will come back with a victory. And we will have greater reasons to rejoice. So I want to encourage all of you to spare 1 hour, not 30 minutes. They recommended 30 minutes, but I'm saying 1 hour. Let the hour of 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. tomorrow be your time of praying. 1 hour is not too much. We are not going to walk. So we can spare the 1 hour to pray. And the Lord will hear us and he will answer us in the mighty name of Jesus. Next Sunday, by the grace of God, you and I will celebrate the resurrection. We will celebrate triumph over the trouble called coronavirus in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I want us to close this service with another song. And asking the Lord to fill us with his power. And then I will close the service. Father to child, spirit to spirit, lighted by your word,
with your bread of life, that's how I come alive, that's how I change my world. Father to child, spirit to spirit, lighted by your word. With your breath of life, that's how I come alive, that's how I change my world. Just breathe your name upon me, breathe. Upon me, breathe. Your
Strength of life, with your power of glory, with your power of resurrection, visit us. As many who are under my voice this morning, or who watch later, who are under any yoke of sickness, breathe your healing unto them. As many who are already under the yoke of coronavirus, Lord, who are privileged to watch things, let your strength be perfected in their system. Heal them by your power. Send your glory to their lives, O God, and crush the strength of that demon in their system. For all your children who are trusting you, I decree, O God, this demon will not be able to come near them. You will save your people. You will guide your children. Lord, they will not fall victim to the hands of the enemy. And Lord, whatever the Illuminati, the demonic powers of this world are scheming at this time, I stand as your oracle. Their plans will not stand. Their agenda will not hold. Jesus is coming. He will confound them. He will confuse them. He will disgrace them. He will dislodge them. And God's glory shall be over this world. Lord, this is the week. Show yourself strong. Show yourself strong. Magnify your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. And may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the blessings, the peace, the joy, the empowerment of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with every one of us, even now and forevermore. This year, we don't feel fails, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord. I am being transformed into the same image.
There was a time I truly believed that I could do it on my own. But all that I found at the end of that road is that concept for me was all wrong. But I found a Savior who turned me around when He placed His love on me. And I will try.